During the summer of 2012, Sunya Fredonia scientist Sherry Mason and her students collected water samples from the Great Lakes, including Lake Erie. She discovered tiny plastic beads that appear to be identical to the microbeads found in exfoliating face and body products.
They're not part of nature, and so nature doesn't know what to do with it.
Mason says these microbeads travel through wastewater treatment plants and into the lakes. Once there, she says, the microbeads attract toxins like PCBs. Fish mistake the microbeads for food, and the dangerous chemicals accumulate in their tissues, so when you eat the fish, you ingest the chemicals.
If you find something in water that shouldn't be there, then ultimately what you're looking at is what's in us.
The Department of Natural Resources in Ohio recently began looking for microbeads and other plastics in Lake Erie. They use a trawl to skim the surface of the lake, drain it, and collect the contents. The samples are then sent to scientists like Sherry Mason for testing.
So we're trying to provide the link as to where those particles are coming from.
Heidi Benson gathers the samples from this wastewater treatment plant each week. She says she has found microbeads each time. The concern raised by what researchers are finding was shared by New York Senator Kirsten Gillibrand during a trip to Plattsburgh last summer.
Thousands of tiny plastic beads flood into our rivers, lakes, and streams when we wash them down the drain. These microbeads are so tiny that it might be surprising how much damage they can actually cause to our ecosystem.
Gillibrand introduced a bill that sailed through Congress late last year and was signed by the president in December. Beginning next year in July of 2017, manufacturers will no longer be allowed to use microbeads in their products. And while similar samples being collected by SUNY Plattsburgh students from both the city's wastewater treatment plant and the lake are finding microbeads, they're also discovering in even greater numbers other types of tiny plastics and synthetic fibers.
We're not seeing a lot of microbeads. We're finding mostly fibers. We have seen a ton of fibers. The majority of the microplastics that we're seeing are fibers. To be seeing it in as many different species of fish, as well as in the cormorants as we are, to be seeing that across those species, the majority of the type that we're seeing is fiber as compared to beads. Maybe we need to start thinking about other origins of other types of plastics and where we can sort of minimize the outflow there, because that appears to be what's moving into the food chain and up into us.